Now, Dune, a cuisine question for you. Have you ever had a deep-fried Mars bar?
I have had a deep-fried Curly Whirly.
Have you really?
Yes.
Did you batter it?
It was battered. In my local chip shop in Fife, you could have the chocolate bar of your choice.
Wow.
You could hold it in the paper. And it's, yeah.
And did it, I mean, was the batter, did the butter cover it completely, or were there still holes?
No, sadly not.
The pierced
sadly
effect.
Not a lattice work of beauty. Yeah. No, just a, just a lump of greasy fat.
Will you stop doing that?
But you can get deep-fried salad.
Oh, well. No.
It's crispy seaweed, otherwise known as.
Oh, good point. That is deep-fried.
But, yes, salad. No, in Scotland, you seem to be able to get anything deep-fried.
But there is some evidence that they've been taking on board the government's advice about health and the Mediterranean diet. You can get deep-fried pizza as well, can't you?
Yep.
Extraordinary, isn't it? Have you ever had it? Well, you've been here many times.
I haven't. You know, I've heard tell of this strange beast.
Yeah.
And many comedians would do jokes about deep-fried Mars bars, but I never had the courage to have them. They're always odd to me, Scottish chip shops generally, you know.
Caliut.
Well, you know, they say, can I have a fish supper? And I, well, supper means and chips. I kind of thought I'd go in and, you know, ask for a supper. Like two lots of chips.
But you could also buy individual cigarettes there, so to add insult to injury. You could also, to add to your heart attack, then buy a single number six and quickly have it.
Yeah.
Fry the
deep fried.
Deep fried. Deep fried Benson and Hedges.
Everything,
really good.
Oh. Everything in there was deep fried. Yeah. You came out, you were deep fried yourself. That is Scottish cuisine.
But, is that not a myth, a deep-fried Mars?
Well, no, it isn't a myth, and that's really why we asked, because some people think it is a myth. It absolutely isn't a myth at all. No, it really, really, really does exist. There's one.
All right, can we talk about herpes again, please?
Well, these are the kind of things you were swimming into when you were
deep-fried.
Pretty horrific.
Deep-fried.
Yeah, there was a Mark Pettigrew of the MRC Social and Public Health Sciences Unit who surveyed 300 shops. 22% of them sold deep-fried Mars bars.
Yeah.
But he also came across deep-fried cream eggs, ice cream bananas and Rolos. And to that we add...
Curly
Whirly. What do they look like again?
I'm not.
Here we go, Jim. In Glasgow, perhaps the least healthy food ever sold is the deep-fried pork sausage kebab. You take a pork sausage, you wrap it in doner kebab meat, coat it in batter and deep fry it.
Oh, stop, I can't breathe.
It's 1,000 of your best calories in 46 grams of fat.
You know, but if you called it, you know, saucisson en croûte avec un coulis superbe, you could charge 25 quid for it.
You could. But instead in Glasgow, they call it a stoner. Do you know what stoner? Do you know what it means? Yeah, it means an erection.
Oh,
it means a stuffy, eh? That's a Scottish accent, apparently.
Which part of Scotland was that?
Well, you know, the part I loved, you know, there's a marvellous story about Maggie Smith when she was going to play Miss Jean Brodie, and she was going, oh, God, I can't do a bloody Scottish accent. And a friend of hers said, well, I've got an aunt who lives in Morningside, which is just the right area for Jean Brodie, that very refined Scottish accent. So call her up and, you know, offer to take her out to tea. And so Maggie Smith called up and said, hello, mine's Maggie Smith. I don't know if you know the novel, The Prime of Miss Jean Brodie. She said, but I'm playing that character and I'd love... apparently you have a very, very charming Morningside accent and I'd like to take you to tea and maybe with a tape recorder. And there was a very frigid pause. She said, my dear, I have been told I have no accent whatever. Completely insulted. And there are Scots... I remember talking to one Scot who spoke a form of Scottish where he was convinced that everyone thought he sounded English. There is absolutely nothing I am saying which ought to lead you to believe that I am Scottish. Absolutely every vowel is pure English, and yet it sounded more Scottish than the worst Glaswegian drunk in a Soho doorway. Carry on.
And you were doing so well.
Yes.
Hey, New Year. They heard that voice at all it goes left.
Really, I've got to say, Stephen, it's been a bewildering array of...